Well, as always, this time during the course of our live Nitro event, we're going to send it on the road on behalf of 1-800-COLLECT. On the road with our good friend, good colleague, Lee Marshall. Lee, how cold is it in Duluth, Minnesota right now?
19 degrees,
oh,
Tony.
Wow.
19, and we're going down to about 13 tonight.
How about that?
I want to make something very clear, and that is that some of the greatest, hardest fought battles ever held within the squared circle have taken place in Minneapolis or in Minnesota, and that's why it's fitting, of course, for me to be at the Nitro Party right here in Duluth a week from tonight. The chill of late winter gets replaced by the red-hot action, excitement at WCW Monday Nitro. In fact, Nitro here in Duluth is sold out. The following Monday, Nitro in Roanoke is SRO. So that means you fans in places like Grand Rapids and Saginaw, Dayton, and Philly, don't get left out in the cold. Get your Nitro tickets at all the outlets and box offices. Now, since I've arrived, I found out that Duluth is the birthplace of Bob Dylan.
Oh.
Yeah, in fact, we're about ready to break into a rousing rendition of that great Dylan tune, Rainy Day Weasels. We tried Mr. Tambourine Weasel, but we didn't know the words. That's your 1-800-COLLECT road report from Duluth, Minnesota. That tell you it was 19 degrees. I'm Lee Marshall for 1-800-COLLECT.
Does that tell you how smart the guy is? It's sold out. What's he doing in Duluth? It's 19 degrees. They got 11 feet of snow. He's wearing earmuffs and a muffler, and he's making fun of me. What an idiot.
Time for our next match. Also, fans, as Lee said, here's where WCW Scott Norton comes out of the NWO.
I'm going to show you why.
Here's where WCW will come in the way. We will be in Dayton, Ohio, the Hare Arena, Friday, April 18th. On Saturday, April 19th, the Van Andel Arena in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Sunday, April 20th, Wings Stadium in Kalamazoo, Michigan. And then Monday, April 21st, Nitro comes to the Civic Center in Saginaw, Michigan. For all four of those venues, tickets will go on sale this Friday, the 21st of March, at the respective box offices and Ticketmaster, with the exception of Kalamazoo, that's the box office and Ticket Plus location. So make sure you get your tickets as WCW in the month of April comes to Ohio and Michigan. All right, Chavo Jr. and Scott Norton one-on-one in this matchup. Scott Norton of the New World Order, and as we said, still to come in this program, as promised, and as they technically can do, the champions will come out, the World Tag Team Champions, Hall and Nash, and wrestle. And, of course, they got that by winning that match last night, thanks to help from Dennis Rodman. And we think back about Rodman's involvement, Mike, today. We all said, no, he's not a pro wrestler, but he is the kind of person and the kind of personality that fits within the mold of the NWO because he will do anything.
Well, he certainly did last night and allowed the New World Order to gain the victory. And for the stipulations, they are in the driver's seat as far as the title picture is concerned. Huge size, power, and experience advantage in this matchup for Norton. He's part of the NWO's international contingent. Years wrestling over in New Japan, and I understand that he's headed back over to the Orient within the next week as part of the NWO versus New Japan. Chavo Jr. is going to have to rely on his speed and quickness to stay one step ahead of the massive Norton in this one.
Chavo.
Look at the power of this Norton.
That was the ill-advised move right there. Look, oh my, you're right, Brain.
I mean, he's got 80 to 100 pounds on Chavo.
Right, that slingshot cross body block, and Norton just dumped him back into the ring.
Really overmatched.
Whoa!
But using his quickness, that's a great move. Drop kick the man on the knee, get the legs out, and Norton trying to stand, and thus, you can get him down.
Take the big man down to the mat, make him the same size.
Well, you don't want to stand there and match strength for strength with this big guy. I don't think you can stand toe-to-toe with him and get him down. But that's what he's got to do. Like you said, Tony, he's got to get him off his feet and then kick his brains in.
Messina, a clothesline, lariat, and Chavo going back to the same point of attack, but Norton just will not go down. Great vertical brace and great balance by the big man showing here as Norton comes back and Chavo tries to go upstairs and connects, but he's still, Norton is just too much of a powerhouse here.
No effect on that missile dropkick off the top by Guerrero.
Whoa.
Oh, whiplash effect as Chavo Guerrero at the back of his head hit the corner.
You know, when you think about what is going on, it's Chavo trying to execute a sunset flip.
Look at this.
Oh, my goodness. When you think about what's going on, we have teams and men and athletes, announcers, people in the front office on both sides of the ledger, NWO and WCW, who are feeling very good about their organization right now. One, two, three. And I tell you, you got to feel good about the
NWO when you see Scott North, if you're a member of the NWO, and how he just mauled through Chavo Jr. right there.
You can't respect a little man like that to deal with somebody like me.
He's mad all the time.
I don't know if he's mad or just determined. Maybe it's mad, I don't know. But
he's determined to be mad.
Yes. Let's go once again to the replay here on Nitro.
Guerrero comes over that top rope.
He dared him to.
Yeah. Norton just caught him. Caught him like a baseball. Pitches him right back into the ring. Now he's going to have some fun with him. Look at the size of this man. The massive man. Now watch this. Picks him up and just drives him into that mat. That was it for Guerrero. There was no more fight left in him. Your winner with a 1-2-3, Scott Flash Norton.
Sports talk shows, ESPN, all the major networks last night discussing the Dennis Rodman's appearance and impact that he had on Uncensored.
And that was his first time at WCW. Think of the impact he made. Think what's going to happen when he's around a little longer.
Yeah, we now have these comments from Hogan and Rodman.
This is the real Hot Rod. I've seen him in action. He passed the initiation. New York City stood still when they shook the man's hand that shook the world. Oh, yeah, Hollywood's hand shook the world. And when I bonded with my blood brother, the real Hot Rod, Sting was stung. Wouldn't you say Sting was stung, brother?
I don't think he was stung. I think he was bewildered.
Oh,
yes, he was bewildered.
I like that.
You know, when come July, man, the Hollywood man with style, man with class, the NWO comes to town. It's the new world order, baby. That's what it's gonna be. Me and my good friend, Hollywood.
It's four.